What's up guys, Jannik here from Calisthenics Family. In this video I'm going to show you guys 5 essential exercises to train your scapula strength. Also I'm going to tell you guys why this is so important for calisthenics. Alright guys, so let me first explain what the scapula is. The scapula is actually your shoulder blade at the back of your shoulder, which connects your upper arm with your shoulder. The muscles surrounding the scapula are really essential when doing calisthenics, because almost any movement you do involves these muscles. Think about basic exercises like the push-up, where your body is leaning on your upper arm through the shoulder, and also the pull-up, where almost your whole body is hanging on your arm through the shoulder. You might think, I can do push-ups and pull-ups easily, why should I train scapula strength? Well, these are just basic exercises, okay? With calisthenics, we are training for skills like the front lever, the back lever and the planche, with the scapula is way more involved. With these exercises, you are not simply leaning or hanging. You are actually lifting almost your whole body from the shoulders. Let's have a closer look at the front and back lever. You can see that the leverage is taking place at the shoulders, where the muscles around the scapula are fully engaged to keep the body on a proper horizontal position. Without solid strength in this area, you won't be able to perform these skills with a proper form and you will have a risk of shoulder injuries. It actually happened to myself. About a year ago, I was practicing for a straight handstand, so I locked my elbows and protracted my scapula as much as I could. And that's where it went wrong. It felt like my shoulder went out of my socket. My scapula just wasn't strong enough. It took me a few weeks to recover and from that moment I started to work on my scapula strength. So next up I'm gonna show you guys exactly which exercises we do to get a strong scapula. The first and the easiest exercise is the scapula push-up with your knees on the ground. In terms of yoga, this is also called the cat to cow pose. With this move you wanna start with the cow pose, where you are lowering your belly towards the ground. That is where you retract your scapula. From here, you are going to move into the cat pose, where you want to raise your shoulder and back as much as you can while pushing your hands into the ground. This is where you protract your scapula. Make sure that your arms are straight with your elbows locked. You should do this exercise for about 8 to 10 repetitions, just like the other exercises. Okay, so the second exercise is the scapula push-up with your elbows on the ground and your feet on the ground. Here you want to make exactly the same movements as the previous exercise. So retract the scapula at the bottom and protract the scapula at the top. The third exercise is the full scapula push-up, so feet on the ground and hands on the ground. With this exercise, you want to make sure that you keep your arms straight with your elbows locked, because you don't want to use the strength of your arms. It should be just your shoulders that are working here. Okay guys, so these were some push exercises. The next exercise are going to be pull exercises. The fourth exercise is the scapula Australian pull-up. For this exercise, you should find a low bar where you can put your feet on the ground or a box. Okay, so now you want to do scapula pull-ups. Make sure that your arms are fully straight with your elbows locked, and make sure that's only your shoulders that are moving. With pull-ups, you want to go from a dead hang position to an active hang where you retract your scapula as much as possible. So you want to move your chest to the bar as much as possible without bending your arms. Alright, so the last exercise is the full scapula pull-up. This one is a bit heavier than the previous exercise, because now you are lifting your whole body. Okay, so you want to make the same movements here. So at the bottom, you want to have a full dead hang position, and from there, you want to retract your scapula as much as possible. So you want to move your head to the bar while keeping your arms straight and your elbows locked. Alright, so these were the exercises that we do to train scapular strength. I want to emphasize again that this body part is really important when you want to do skills with a proper form. We are actually doing these 5 exercises in our warming up routine before every workout, which is 4 times per week. And sometimes, about 1 or 2 times per week, we are doing a shoulder mobility routine where we've implemented these exercises as well. So that's about 5 to 6 times per week. I just realized that we are doing these exercises almost every day. I think that says enough about its importance, right? By the way, about this shoulder mobility routine, we've got a lot of questions to make a video about this, so we're going to do this very soon, and if you'd like to see that, make sure to keep up to date. So I hope that this video was informational for you, and if you want to see more informational videos about anything, please let us know in the comments and we will make that happen. If you like this video or if it helped you, please put a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe if you haven't yet, and we hope to see you at the next video. Peace out, guys.